Good day and welcome back to Practical Christian Living with me, Jonathan Phillips. In Ezekiel 36 verse 26, it says, I will give you a new heart and put in a new spirit in you. I will remove your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. What is this process that is described here in Ezekiel in the Old Testament? This is the moment when you have given your heart over to God. Is that not the wording that we use? Have you given your heart to the Lord? What is it saying? It means that there's an exchange that has taken place. You're exchanging what is spoken of here, the heart of stone for a heart of flesh. What does it mean? Why are you saying heart of flesh? I thought I'm not supposed to walk in the flesh. That's not what the Bible is saying. It's describing a stony heart, which is a heart that is not receptive to God. A stone is not receptive to emotion. A stone is not receptive to the things around it. It's just a dead weight. And when we walk around with these hearts of stone, the anointing of God can be hovering all around you, the presence of God, the joy of God, but you will be untouched because of your heart of stone. Nothing can penetrate a stone. It's difficult to penetrate a stone. So here, what it's saying in Ezekiel is that trade has to take place. And if you say you've given your heart to God, it means you no longer have the heart of stone, but the heart that is sensitive unto God. So a new heart indicates a new direction. So if you are moving in a certain direction, once you've given your heart over to God, it means you no longer walk in the same direction and in the same way that you've been walking in. It means there's a new flow to your life. If you had a negative flow, it will change to something of a positive nature. It's a new way of doing things. Your habits begin to change because you no longer have the stony heart. You have a heart of flesh. So your way of doing things is different. You speak different. Some people even begin to walk different. With confidence they walk. It's a new way of seeing things. In the past, you used to view negative things just as negative, but now you look for the silver lining in the cloud all the time. When things happen to you, you don't react in the same way, the way you used to when you had a heart of stone. It's a new way of feeling. Often when we give our hearts to the Lord, we become sensitive to His presence, but also our emotional state becomes a bit stable. Let me say more than a bit, it becomes stable. But what I'm trying to say is, man is emotional by nature. That is something that God has built into man in order for man to, you know, God uses the emotional states as a method for man to detect what's happening around him or her. So when we become saved and when we give our hearts to the Lord, when this exchange takes place, now I'm not so emotional as what I used to be. Does it mean I'm dead as a robot? No. It simply means my emotions is intact. I'm fully aware of what I'm feeling, but the difference now is I know why I'm feeling and I know what I need to do with this feeling. Whereas if I have a heart of stone, there's no control. If I'm feeling angry, I go to the extreme of anger. If I feel sad, I go to the extreme of sadness. But when I have this heart of flesh and I begin to reason with this heart of flesh that God has given me, now I understand that I'm sad. Lord, why am I sad? Let me find a remedy for the sadness. Why am I angry? Oh, I understand I'm angry because that happened and is linked to this value system in my life. So now I understand it. So my reaction is not an outburst, but it's controlled now. So this is the start of your testimony. And your testimony requires you to think in this way. So, beloved, as I've unpacked this whole scenario with regards to heart of flesh or heart of stone, where do you find yourself today? There's no middle ground. You can't have a half stone, half flesh. The Bible refers to that as lukewarm, I believe. When you say that you've given your heart to the Lord, there should be evidence. It would be very silly if you say, I've given my heart to the Lord, but the evidence in your life, the fruit in your life, speaks of a heart of stone. It's very difficult, virtually impossible for a heart of flesh to behave like a heart of stone because the two are on opposite ends of the scale. So when you have a heart of flesh, you automatically gravitate towards the things of God. So may we today embrace the heart that God has given us, that the love of God and all of these things. Let us allow this to transform us and not conform. Amen.